Today's tools for knife making video is the Tapmatic 30X. I love this thing. Today I want to talk to you about one of my all-time favorite tools in the shop. It's not the drill press, no, it's the Tapmatic. This is the Tapmatic 30X, and this is how I tap these tiny little 2x56 screws. This is a 30X. It's the smallest size Tapmatic you can get. This is a reversible tapping head. It has a clutch in it, and the way this thing works, the drill press turns, it's winding up a spring in here, and then there's a clutch, and then it self-reverses as the spring unwinds. Mine did not come with the arbor, so actually that's a bolt that I threaded and tapped and cut off. Works just fine. You can see here it has a max RPM. I just stick this in my drill press and it makes tapping tiny holes a breeze. I love this tool. It's probably my favorite tool in the shop. Up here is your adjustment for the clutch, softer or harder. And you do have this long arm. This has to rest against something solid. Some people trade these out and put a longer one that rests on the back of their drill press. It tells you specifically, don't hold the arm, this stop arm in your hand. You might want to let that rest against the back of your drill press. And here's their website. Check out the Tapmatic.com website. I'm not affiliated, but they have a great link for determining your feeds and speeds based on the size of the tap and the material that you're tapping. I have only ever used my Tapmatic for through holes. I've never tapped a blind hole with it. There is some competition to the Tapmatic called the Prochner. I'll put the link in the description. I'm not sure if I'm saying the name of the company right. Again, I only use my Tapmatic for through holes. And as far as tapping titanium, it works so good. And I'll demonstrate that here briefly on a piece of trash titanium turned into a tooling plate. So what I'm doing now is I'm making a new tooling plate. I'm making a new tooling plate because I have made my vessel for my anodizer smaller. And so I'm trying to make this tooling plate smaller too. So the first thing I'm going to do is drill a bunch of holes in this at 5/64 of an inch. That's a 078 drill bit, and that's what I have set up in the drill press at 078. Let's zoom in and punch some holes real quick. You can see I've drilled some 078 holes. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to chamfer these before I attempt to tap it. This is just a mill drill I'm going to use to chamfer these holes. So I'm getting ready to chamfer these holes with a 90-degree chamfer drill. In the perfect world, you would have a drill press bank. Several drill presses set up permanently, the Tapmatic installed in one of them. I only have one drill press, so I actually have to still change my drill bits and put this thing in and out. But whatever, that's not a problem. This makes tapping small, tiny 2x56 holes extremely easy. Anytime you lower your drill press table, anytime you change the height of your drill press table, you always want to make sure that you have upward force before you lock it down. The tables tend to dip. You want to raise them up before you lock them. I need to change the speed here real quick. You see here I got a cheat sheet on the inside. If you're wondering what kind of tap I use a Morse. I also use these two lubes. I have Rapid Tap and Magic Tap. Tap Magic on this piece of titanium. I also have the rapid tap. I like it too, but mostly for drilling holes. It's a little bit heavier. So you want to hold this flat, and we're going to tap this in no time. So I love the Tapmatic. If you're very serious about your knife making and you want to move into folders, I highly, highly recommend that you obtain one of these. They're not cheap, and they work fabulous. I'm trying to keep this video under 7 minutes. I appreciate you watching all the way through. You must like knife making. If you do, please subscribe. New videos come out on Wednesdays. Thanks for watching.